สวัสดีค่ะ Good Sunday from the International Program of Communication Arts for ASEAN. Today is quite special because we have the music for motivating us to the special program tonight. Tonight we have a very special guest speaker. We are very honored to welcome you. He is the Executive Director of Media Agency Association of Thailand.And also the chief director of executive strategy and Kaiser in IPG Consulting Media Brand. And besides from that, he's a PhD candidate in Kaiser International Communication. May we please welcome Khun Sola Kiet Khanarat, please. Welcome, Khun Sola. Very honored to have you with us tonight. Thank you.We have a lot of audience tonight, and then our student also from Singapore. He's a Navy, and also some of our master degree program in Thai program of STU, and some of the Kasetsart University. Everyone is very interesting in the new normal, and how can we use ICT and the media.To move on any kinds of innovation to stay along with the new normal. So I think that's your duty is very important tonight. Welcome. Go ahead, please. Thank you.
Okay. Yes. Thank you very much for having me tonight. นะครับ So let's be open the floor. นะครับ If you have any question during the presentation or during the discussion, you can leave the question in the message chat. นะครับ And I will try to answer it at the end. นะครับ So let me share the slide up first. นะครับCan you all see this slide?
Yes, clear.
Okay, ครับ. So once again, นะครับ thank you for having me. And today we will talk about the innovation in communication. What happening after the COVID or even now? We almost passed the COVID already. I hope everyone stay healthy and stay committed to what you are doing, นะครับ. So as we all see that now today, even this class happen online.And that is already the first of the new normal that we can talk about today. And to me, I think the STOU is actually the pioneer in distant learning, actually, because we have been on the distant learning over 20 years already through the satellite or through the television. But this pandemic or the COVID-19 make the big change that everyone is now pushed toward digital นะครับ so that we are move forward and adapt have to adapt more นะครับ but before we getting into the detail of those information let me introduce IPG media brand a little bit นะครับ okay so I'm currently working as a chief strategy officer and the CEO of IPG Consulting and IPG Media Brand. นะครับ so I'm taking care of the strategy and develop the innovation for the group. นะครับ IPG Media Brand is a global network. นะครับ of the company. นะครับ we listed in the stock exchange in New York and we have the branches across the world about in 100 country. นะครับ operating in the advertising, communication and producing creative work.นะครับ right now we have about 54,000 employees working at IPG Media Brand across the 100 countries that I mentioned already นะครับ and these are the function at the company that we operating across the world นะครับ range from the creative solution on the left side นะครับ and media marketing service digital specialization and integrating agency นะครับ the reason I'm showing this function is thatIs the new normal already นะครับ media or advertising agency doesn't only do the content or advertising นะครับ we do much more beyond that นะครับ if you look at the left side it's still the creative which we have two agencies three of the all these agencies are in Thailand as well นะครับ on the second row we have media brand นะครับ and other function นะครับsome of these function already beyond digital as well we into big data analysis we into programmatic we are into the data analytic นะครับ or even create a predictive modeling meaning that we can forecast if the investment in certain media will produce the sale or not will create the bottom line or not นะครับ so that is a solution นะครับ and marketing service is another round นะครับ pretty much talk in the old time we pretty much talk about event or activation or IMC but right now นะครับ event or activation go beyond that it go to licensing นะครับ like octagon dominate sport event we have licensing we have merchandising we have giftWe have souvenir and all of those are under the service นะครับ and so forth นะครับ so that is the operation นะครับ in Thailand IPG Media Brand we have this much นะครับ so still cover most of the function except the one in the integrated in the US นะครับ so under Media Brand I look after the strategy of all these function นะครับ initiative UM VPN and reprise mainly the media agency so we do planning buying of the media both traditional and digital media นะครับ reprise is specialization in the e-commerce so they do a lot of e-commerce for client like airline or insurance นะครับ that they are doing นะครับBelow that Ensemble นะครับ Ensemble is a creative agency of the year last year and the year before that นะครับ the reason that we have become the Thailand creative agency of the year because it's a nowadays creativity needs to come with data and Ensemble capitalize on that they merge the knowledge of data big data analytic to develop the content so that's why we integrated นะครับCadrian is another emerging trend นะครับ programmatic which I will touch upon later on นะครับ and I also look after the consultancy unit and then another unit is data analytics which coming in hot at the moment so this is a Thailand operation นะครับ so this is my friend at the office we right now we have about 285 people working at IPG Media Brand and we ran about 10 billion นะครับ of media billing annually for our client นะครับ soThat is pretty much what we are doing, and I'm right here in the middle with my chairman, นะครับ and we operating in Thailand since 1970. It used to be Lintas Thailand, นะครับ at the beginning, and right now we are by IPG Media Brand, นะครับ but again, นะครับ I'm to emphasize on that, นะครับ the reason that I'm talking about IPG Media Brand just to paint the picture for you guys to understand the new normal of communication that.There are no more two function or three function. There are almost 10, 20, 30 function that we have to work together to integrate all the communication to the consumer in this new normal. นะครับ And that's why we have a lot of these function coming in or popping in into the industry or into the workforce. นะครับ Lastly, initiative is Thailand number one quality agency in Thailand. The reason we do that because we uphold the quality highly.We have least turnaround in terms of client. Most of the clients stay with us for a really long time. นะครับ One of our client has been with us for 45 years already. They have never changed any agency. นะครับ And most of the client that we have stay with us for over 10 years. And that's why นะครับ We are number one in terms of quality. นะครับ So let's talk about today's topic. นะครับ If you look at this chart, นะครับ You can see a lot of innovation coming in. นะครับI think only me and อาจารย์ are in the era of AOL and Yahoo นะครับ that the first platform on email that we are using in long time ago นะครับ and if we look at the lead time you can see that in the old time it took longer than 10 years to develop one innovation นะครับ and it getting shorter and shorter and shorter นะครับ right now that we are sitting here ZoomFor instance, นะครับ another virtual meeting platform only spend only few months to develop itself and now it's become almost surpass Facebook already. So that's how the rapid innovation coming in into the consumer and how open that we adopt that innovation. นะครับ so it's going very fast. นะครับ and if we look at some of the data right now, นะครับ in terms of mobile data, นะครับ right now digital satellite or television นะครับ out of the population 70นะครับ the data claim from Nielsen that already 100% นะครับ penetration already on digital satellite นะครับ but if we revert to mobile subscription นะครับ you can see that each person has more than two phone because the penetration is 135 while the subscription is 93นะครับ so you must have two or three number for usageAnd internet is almost 100% already, นะครับ so that how fast that the innovation moving on, นะครับ And this is the ownership. You can look into your home, นะครับ or look into your pocket. How many mobile phone you have in your pocket, นะครับ Right now, the device ownership, นะครับ 94% of Thai people already have mobile phone or smartphone, นะครับ 50% already have laptop, นะครับ or tablet, นะครับ And wearable is coming hot like the smartwatch, นะครับAnd in the near future, นะครับ IoT or Internet of Things will soon coming in and making all the smartwatch นะครับ communicating to you or even your refrigerator can tell you that the pork is out or you need to buy some milk นะครับ your air condition can tell you that the weather is not good นะครับ it's coming here already นะครับ it depends on how can us utilize those innovation to communication นะครับ and this is how much time spent นะครับespecially now that we are staying home most of the time นะครับ internet นะครับ daily usage is approximately 9 hours already of our time นะครับ you wake up the first thing that you grab is mobile phone นะครับ and then so and so far you check throughout the day internet and mobile and tv and live stream นะครับ I was wondering actually when have we ever work or ever study because we spend a lot of time or almost all the time online already นะครับSo that this is the situation that happening right now, นะครับ and watching video online, blog, listen, and the recent activity that most of people are now doing is TikTok, นะครับ I think most of you or all of you already try that, and maybe you may have a TikTok channel of yourself already, นะครับ it become fun and phenomenal in such a short period that the new communication coming in as a playing toolright now almost surpass Facebook or the consumption of other already นะครับ and in the field of communication TikTok become another platform นะครับ that already have the communication package sell to agency and have the influencer on TikTok already to help drive all those thinking or all those product to the consumer นะครับ so that is what is emerging นะครับ and to highlight นะครับ it's not only the new generation นะครับ that adopt the innovation you can see this generation from Gen Z, Gen Y, Gen X, and Baby Boomer, นะครับ If you look at the graph, นะครับ the red one is watching TV yesterday, นะครับ and the blue one is mobile phone usage yesterday, นะครับ 14, the mobile phone usage is more than television, นะครับ However, the interesting point is that even for Gen X or Baby Boomer, the mobile phone usage is almost the same as TV already, นะครับ So that shows how much innovation in digital or in mobile phoneComing into our life across all age, not just in the younger one. นะครับ so I think digital communication for everyone or the innovation adoption, นะครับ if we can understand it, we can use it wisely. It's going to be beneficial to the communication team or brand or marketing, นะครับ because it's already across all age already at the moment. นะครับ and we are not only do the watching TV or watching YouTube or watching content, นะครับA lot of search is very important, นะครับ purchase online become emerging a lot, นะครับ especially during this isolation time, นะครับ a lot of us that has never purchased Tesco or merchandising through Big C online, right now they are doing that already, นะครับ a lot of home delivery coming in, a lot of food delivery coming in, นะครับ because of the new normal coming, นะครับ and that's why we are now rapidly moving towardthe digital at the moment นะครับ and very important is that Thailand นะครับคนไทยไม่แพ้ใครในโลกนะครับคือthe level of purchasing online is very high นะครับ 82% of the people who are already online has purchased something already so it's not a fear anymore that you're gonna spend online it's now become an opportunity for all the marketer actually that can sell everything online นะครับ even I have been into one case study นะครับ one of the best selling is actually egg ไข่ไก่ครับ we have never thought about ไข่ไก่ being delivered to the house but frankly speaking or surprisingly online purchase of ไข่ไก่ or egg is quite high นะครับ or even something else นะครับ so now it's a new normal นะครับ and the interesting thing another interesting fact is that the shortest distance that people order onlineIt's only 5 meter นะครับ people order ice from 7-Eleven through online นะครับ and their house and that 7-Eleven is only 5 meter away นะครับ so แค่5กิโลเขาก็สั่งออนไลน์แล้วไม่ต้องซื้อนะครับ so I got this data from another platform นะครับ so that's how finger or the mobile phone become a new life facilitation. So we can use this phone to manage our life, almost everything, even in education that we are doing now today. And if you are into selling or purchasing or being an influencer on this business, these are the interesting number that you can see. People are purchasing through online. This one is from the e-commerce for Thailand. Purchasing travel, selling product, electronic, fashion, furniture, even furniture online. So if you are interested in doing e-commerce or something, or don't have any idea of what to sell yet, these are the most item that people are doing online, even music. And that is the changes that we see. Because if we talking about the theory a little bit, we used to have a linear adoption cycle. Awareness, interest, design, action, that is a linear. Now today it's almost dynamic and diverse already. There's no flat line. Everything go back and forth. You can imagine yourself, if you want to buy a mobile phone, you might go search online first, and then you go to the shop and to see a real one, right? And you go back online to see the price or compare price and look at the review. You might come back to the shop again, and then you purchase it online. So that is how diverse or how the change of the communication or the funnel is changing. So it's from the normal flat journey into the more of the my personal own path. If I want to purchase the mobile phone, my journey might be different from Ajahn Kamolat or Kun Pami. So each individual journey is different, and that's why the innovation in communication has to be able to capture all these differences in order to create an effective communication. Especially right now, that it's not only the science anymore, it's also the art in combination. Or it's not only the art anymore, it's also the science. Because of the digital, so we can trace or track all the data that happening in the communication world. And we can use those data to develop content or idea to capture them, or to capture the communication piece. And that's why it's a combination of these both worlds. I have one of the example that I can show you now. Not sure if the voice is going to work or not, but it doesn't matter about what is the new journey that happened in the communication. Did the voice get through? เสียงผ่านเข้าไปไหมครับ
ไม่ผ่านค่ะไม่ผ่านแต่ไม่เป็นไรยังพอได้
ครับ So let's me explain a little bit นะครับ so they were talking about the journey of the consumer นะครับ let's say that you begin the morning you searching for some shoes in your mobile phone นะครับ and you found that there's no shoe and your sizeavailable in the mobile phone. Once you go out of your home and you walk nearby that shop, that shop will send a signal to alert you that there's a shoe of your size that you're looking for this morning in the shop. That is an example of the real-time data management right now that can do the geolocation mapping onto your mobile phone, onto the real location, and send you a real-time content that you can purchase right away.นะครับ and that is why the innovation is important in tapping into each individual journey or purchasing funnel นะครับ and these are the three keys emerging innovation that help enableize all those function นะครับ the fintech we have been hearing about it for a long time there are so many level of fintech นะครับ martech is quite new one it's marketing technology that's coming in right now already นะครับ already exists in Thailand นะครับ adtech has been here for a couple of years already and it's getting more and more advanced นะครับ let's go into one by one นะครับ for fintech นะครับ the simplestthing is that you purchase something online and you pay it online is part of the fintech already นะครับ and that facilitate a lot of communication or branding branding strategy นะครับ because right now if people can pay online there are so many way that we can convince them or persuade them to purchase something or some brand นะครับ in term of fintech นะครับ in Thailand นะครับ people we have to build this ecosystem นะครับ first we have the product online นะครับThere, the consumer has to be able to search and find your product. So you need to have a search strategy in place as well, นะครับ as a part of innovation. And once they visit and purchase, we have to collect those data and retarget or revisit them if they want something else, นะครับ So that is the financial beginning of the fintech that we can capture consumer in นะครับ and as I mentioned นะครับ people already purchase a lot online already นะครับ and here is some easy example of what we are doing นะครับ as simple as the left one นะครับ SCB แม่มณีนะครับ when we do the QR testing or downloading the QR couple of years ago นะครับ we build the team of almost over 100 troopgoing to the location to convince people or educate people to download and use แม่มณีนะครับไปที่ go to the fresh market go to motorcycle taxi go to many places นะครับ and then that's how we turn people to adopt this innovation for about 7 million people in the first year นะครับ that's the basic function of fintech I think some of you may already have already on QR payment the next fintech is partly integrated within the digital platform or the e-commerce platform นะครับ like when you go purchase in Lazada if you pay right away on Lazada that already financial technology นะครับ and the most advanced one is talking about Bitcoin or the digital encryptนะครับ cryptocurrency นะครับ so that is another fintech in another next level but for communication or branding we mostly doing dealing fintech with e-commerce or the payment on mobile นะครับ and that shorten the journey a lot because if people can pay on mobile they can pay anywhere even you are in your bed almost sleeping you can shopping นะครับ and that is the moment that the communicator has to understand and capture นะครับThe second one in connecting to the now that we have the financial infrastructure, the second one is marketing technology. นะครับ that is coming in. นะครับ the overview picture of marketing technology is that right now we have a lot of challenge. Look, you can see a lot of company trying to reorganize or using the agility model to change their company. นะครับ because they already know already that the finance or the fintech.นะครับ already here, so the business model had to change. นะครับ because it's not onlyTalking about the finance thing is also talking about the operation นะครับ because if people can purchase thing online it means that operation at their factory or that their inventory has to be connected นะครับ so the marketer can check their stock if they have enough product or not if people purchase and get delivery or not นะครับ all together at the same time นะครับ and the challenge being now is thatThe chain of the organization being too slow or slower than the adoption level of consumer นะครับ and that's why they are in need of people who can help with this marketing technology or martech นะครับ and right now there are a lot of martech technology that's servicing you นะครับ or you can use apply to rank from the awareness building down into the conversion purchasing or analyze ครับ and this martech is different from ad tech or advertising technology a little bit in the term that marketing technology help facilitate marketer นะครับ to do with their sale their inventory their trade marketing นะครับ their traceable of their inventory นะครับ as well as the programmatic understanding of the data of consumer that they have in house so that they can understand the consumer better they understand who buy them who not buy them better นะครับ andMartech example นะครับ as easy as what we are doing now นะครับ the first one all the education now even my son นะครับ right now study live 5 hours a day online every day because of this นะครับ so the school or the university change their marketing strategy to do more and more of online less of the physical meeting and which is also better for student because it's more flexible easier to manage นะครับAll the payment online, นะครับ is now marketing technology already, นะครับ equipped into advertising already. When we send the ad to you and you can click on it and you can purchase on it, นะครับ Or even food delivery, นะครับ Or the latest one, นะครับ Before we are now in stage 3, we have the exercise at home, นะครับ A lot of classes open that you can follow and exercise. So that is a marketing technology that changed to follow the new behavior.The last thing is the advertising technology or ad tech นะครับ let me ask you นะครับ you can imagine นะครับ if you go search one day you go search for a mobile phone and then you leave it and you go to check your Facebook or go to your email have you noticed that that ad or that mobile phone is keep following you for the last for the another 2 or 3 weeks นะครับ and that is one of the ad tech that happening นะครับThe advertiser นะครับ right now change from buying a location or buying a spot or time นะครับ into buying consumer นะครับ advertising technology help doing that buying consumer meaning that we understand the brand owner understand who is the most likely person to buy their product and they only select to communicate to that person นะครับ not everyone just that personนะครับ so is this more chance for that person to buy the product than spend all the money to everyone นะครับ and that is a part of the marketing advertising technology that help you identify that person นะครับ from the online data signal if that person oftenly search about mobile phone or not if they have visit purchasing site or not if they have look at the comparison of between brand and brand or not นะครับ how those data will be captureAnd send into the platform so the advertiser can select that person or that ID to communicate one-on-one with them นะครับ into the platform นะครับ and ad tech answering the two need clearly นะครับ as the advertiser now today want to be more focused be more effective in their spending or their budgeting นะครับ and protect their brand image save timead tech help them do that because it can help select person select the right moment select the right location นะครับ so I can even tailor the ad to only send to the office building in Sathon at 12 o'clock at noon to the person who are between 20 to 25 with the medium income who have interest in mobile phone นะครับ we can select it due down to that levelนะครับ and at the same time นะครับ if you are the brand owner or the content owner นะครับ it more on collecting all this data monetize this data นะครับ and we can create brand loyalty better communicate to the same person longer and longer because we know exactly their behavior who they are นะครับ and what they are doing or what they like to purchase or do นะครับand here an example นะครับ let me try again if the voice coming in นะครับ this is a case from the Cannes Lion last year this one the Grand Prix Award last year นะครับ it is full of the advertising technology or ad tech equipped into this case ครับ
Burger King wants you to come here. Yes to McDonald's.
Burger King is trolling its fast food rival
with a promotion available through the Burger King mobile app.
Yeah, but there is a small catch.
So I saw this Burger King commercial where you can
get a Whopper for a penny.
Only if you open the app while you're at McDonald's.
That doesn't even make sense. You have to go to McDonald's for a Whopper?
Whopper?
Use Burger King's BK app,
then be within 600 feet of a McDonald's restaurant.
Burger King geofenced over 14,000.
14,000 McDonald's restaurants in the U.S.
Unbelievable.
So I parked my news car about 100 feet from a McDonald's.
I'm at McDonald's getting a coupon for Burger King. I almost feel like I'm stealing.
Let's go for the unlock.
Yes!
You unlocked the Whopper detour.
This is a really cool promo, guys. How fun is this?
That's crazy.
This is an amazing use of technology to get consumers out of a rival store and into your own store.
Can you do a Whopper Jr.?
It probably can make that. It wouldn't be as good as Burger King would, to be honest with you. Okay, where's the Burger King?
Like 4 blocks to your left.
Okay. This time the sound work, may have.
Worker.
Okay, so only when you drive close to McDonald's, you get a promotion from Burger King, right? So the advertiser at tech doing that job in geolocation, focusing on the nearby of a McDonald's, only the person who drive close to there and they send that promotion right away. Right? So that is how we actually steal the consumer of another competitor to our brand, right? Using ad tech. And that is another innovation that now we are already doing in Thailand. Right? So I think that I'm going very fast. I hope you can understand. You can get the graphs of what the innovation that already coming in and what is the innovation in Thailand that we are having. Right? So after this, I'm very happy if you have any question. Right?
Yeah, thank you so much. It's very touching for kind of bombarding of technology innovation, but anyhow with the base of communication. Any feedback from the floor, please? I think we also have some question from the chat room also. Yes. Yes. Okay. Any feedback from the floor, please? Kunwala from Singapore, any kinds of similarity from Singapore? There are also some question from the chat room that is talking about the active model of production. Would you please see at the chat room? I can see it now. Yep. Okay.
The question is about the agility. Here is a model or production development. I think agility model is quite broad. Right? It's coming it within the internal operation, right? That you have to change the operation from within the company. Right? The agility model change from the isolated function of marketing team, financial team, communication team into the team of the group of experts, very small team. And they change from the objective oriented or the KPI oriented to OKR, which is the objective key result to measure their performance. Right? So it's come within the operation team and come into the product development. And also it's moved into the advertising or communication development later on. Right? So it's the end-to-end process, right? In terms of agility.
End-to-end process, yes.
End-to-end process, right? The clear, the biggest example that we can see is, I think, is SCB or ธนาคารไทยพาณิชย์นะครับ if we can see that the change in the agility model from the internal staff that released the news talking about the operation ใช่ไหมครับ and now they having the already having the financial technology that help facilitate us and they are moving on into more and more financial technology ครับ and communication also change into that way
yep okay great so any reflection from the class please actually this topic is quite jumping from what we have previously because previously we have talking about arsenization and humanism yeah. and kind of that development issue kind of that so this tonight we are jumping in kind of ICT and innovation kind of that so any reflection please Connie you would like to say something
Yes.
Okay.
From the development of ICT, do you think is it significantly change danger of human communication?
Actually, significant change, นะครับ เพราะว่า the interface that we are using or the portal that we are using right now is almost intelligent already. It can forecast our behavior using AI technology. So even though we think we control our thought, somehow that communication has the power to influence us, right? Because if the AI learning our behavior already, it will repeat that behavior and answering to us. So it gonna be quite challenging for us to change our own pattern out of that. Not later on. So that's why I feel that the human interface is quite changing. And another thing is I think the distant lifestyle also changed us a lot. Right now, we don't have to touch money already. We only touch our phone, right? We don't have to touch the shop or the food or don't have even like the car. We touch our phone, right? We don't even have to go wash our clothes. We touch our phone. Everything is on the phone. So that's why if the communication and marketing and technology come together, the mobile phone will be the next life facilitation that's gonna happen. And we see that a lot already in China. China is way beyond us already. And Singapore is already coming too.
Yeah, we have our friend from Singapore. Khun Vala, would you like to share something from Singapore context, please?
Yes. Good evening, instructors. May I ask you some questions?
Yes.
What is the agency that control the like a shopping online activity have a law to control them
oh.
when the customers lose their benefit from the maybe didn't. Receive the parcels, didn't receive the goods from the seller who held them.
If it's in that area, it's a local government and local law that control them. So each of the platform had to obey to the local government or local law, but depend on the operation of different platform. Some platform, they don't have their own shop. They only facilitate the shop upfront. To be the channel, right? And they sell from one shop to you and select from another shop to you. What they can do most is to complain on that shop and use the local legal to reinforce on that shop, particularly. But some shop that they own the product, that's different story. The legal can reinforce them directly. So there's two different platforms. But most of the platform that we are using is mostly a market. We call it marketplace. Marketplace being that. The name of the channel itself is just a market, and they sell product from one brand or another supplier or another SME through them. So that's why they cannot 100% control that shop. We have to use a local to reinforce them. But most of the platform have the screening criteria already on that. So I think the problem may occur, but they have to fix it one by one.
So that you means. Not 100% that can check is a real seller or fake seller in the shopping application or shopping online.
Yes and no, depend on the platform, as I mentioned. Like if it's a big platform like Lazada, they already show you where is the shop, right? Who is the owner, where it's located, mm-hmm. and what is the ranking or rating of that shop. So you can be sure about that, who they are. But some of the portal may not have that ability to trace back, and that become a risk. Right? So that's why when we as a consumer select that, or we as a policy maker to do that, we have to be careful look into that. Right? Because I know right now there's a lot of emerging gray area kind of shop coming in, and that is quite 50% risk. Right?
Okay. How and the last question, how to promote the precaution to the customer shopping online? That how should they precaution to order some goods in some shop, something like that?
Okay. I think right now a lot of the e-commerce platform using the rating to promote, right? This one is a 5-star rating. So they will see, you can see the detail that they have their 100% delivery, 0% complaint or something like that. And people go and look down at those review and they select one over the other, right? And of course, another thing is pricing. This shop might come with a little bit higher price due to their trust and level of credibility, but I think we have to wait on that. But that's a review system.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Any voices? Any more voices? So the as you are nurse, Connie, so once you listen to the topic tonight, what is the emerging issue in your brain?
I have no idea.
Data privacy.
Connie is a nurse, so she's come from medical background. So it's a innovation and marketing technology is quite far from you all, right? But anyhow, in medical science, a lot of technology also, right? Yeah.
I think if we talk about medical, right now the telemedicine is coming in. Yeah, the distant telemedicine, like consultant to the basic diagnostic, right? In some country already operate that you don't have to go to the doctor. You can have application in there, and if you review the application, you can set a schedule to see face to face on your mobile phone to the doctor, right? Or especially right now that 5G already in Thailand already, if they are fully operated, we can do a distant operation even, right? That we can have the very great doctor from the US or somewhere, or the great doctor from Thailand operating people in the US through 5G. So the doctor can stay in Thailand and there's a machine in the US that operating according to the doctor control in Thailand. Already exists. Right? You can go see at Asiam Paragon in true.
Yeah. So I think that we can see this kind of situation more and more clearly from day to day, right?
Yeah.
So the once you are talking about innovation, technology, and then kind of the new normal, kind of that, and then how can the technology or innovation communicate themselves to the human being? So this is the topic for tonight, right? We have a lot of very high-end technology. We have a lot of innovation, but it's totally standalone. It's never talked to human being, right? So I would like to discuss with Khun Sorat that how about the new normal in ASEAN boundary? What do you think about what will happening up in kind of using communication, innovation in this kind of ASEAN or Southeast Asia boundary, please?
Very interesting. I think we have been using it quite a lot already, but it's availability and the type of innovation in different countries different. Like if it's in China, in China themselves, they have their own operation. They don't have Facebook, they don't have YouTube, right? They are on Weibo and they are on different platforms. So that is the other one. But the fundamental of this innovation or technology is the same. นะครับ While us in Thailand, we love to use LINE. In some Asian country, they love to use WhatsApp. นะครับ So it's on different platform, but it is the same innovation. But I think commonly, นะครับ if we are managing the brand that operate in many country, you can do the overall strategy on that brand.นะครับ that how you would like to contact your target how would you like to emerge them innovation is just a tool ครับ and it can be localized to that use but the overall strategy is the more important thing that if we can understand the different person different culture in different country and come up with the master plan for the region นะครับ that will be ideal work for everyone actually because it's gonna go together and move together as an ASEAN for instance นะครับ if we have a Thai brandThat want to go to Southeast Asia, นะครับ You would love to know differences between different country, different innovation in different country, different consumer, นะครับ So we can understand how we can enter into that market, enter to into that zone and capture the heart of that consumer, ครับ By having a master plan for ASEAN or for Southeast Asia, นะครับ And a lot of the client that I'm handling doing that at the moment, ครับ
You also mentioned about the Kaizup example of the ASEAN boundary of the blending about Sa Khon Kaen or Si Chan or Thao Kaen Noi or even Bamrung Rat medical hub kind of that. You would like to share this issue a bit?
I think this is an opportunity for Thai brand at the moment, right? Because a lot of Asian people love Thai brand actually. They love Thai people, they love Thai brand because Thai brand represent a lot of good quality, right? And that's why it's a good opportunity for us to export our own brand, right? And a lot of the client mentioned is they has already studied the opportunity in those market that they want to go in, right? A lot of cosmetic brand, a lot of hospital brand, no? As we know in the news, already expand into that market. And they are use the master strategy or master plan for the Asian growth นะครับ, from Thailand. And then they go into that market and use the local technology or innovation to communicate in that. But the core platform of branding remain the same. ครับ, as the branding positioning or communication has to be unique to the brand. So we have to be true to ourselves. And คนไทยไปที่ไหนก็เป็นคนไทยอะครับแต่ว่า when we go there then we talk in their language use their tool but we are remaining Thai and that is how we manage regional Thai brand
yep this is the reason why we have to stick to our ASEAN identity ASEAN community kind of thatSo Thai has their own identity. ASEAN also have their own identity. So this is the reason why we have to create this program because we want to communicate ASEAN identity to the other region or to the global market. So this is another perspective. That is how innovation, technology communicate themselves about ASEAN to the global market.So yeah. I think that by tonight, even though we are very alert about kinds of innovation technology, but finally, Khun Sola also get back to the fundamental point that is communication is still being the sign and us art and sign, even though it's back and forth all the time, but actually it has its own principle. It has its own theory.Actually, tonight, Khun Sorlat planning to share with you about how human being adopt technology, how human being adopt innovation, but we have very limited time, right? He is the guru in trying of adopt technology and adopt innovation. For example, like Connie would like to offer your hospital to be the medical hub of ASEAN. It's kind of innovation idea.How can you make the other member country adopt this idea, this kind of? So we need to understand the theory, the concept, and the boundary of not only communication, but also technology and innovation, right? So I think that we also welcome for any kinds of feedback, and then we will let Khun Sola to say some word before he's leaving us. Please. I think some question.
Yeah, that's a question about the privacy hack, ใช่ไหมครับ I think the data privacy is another issue that is coming in. I'm actually working on it at the moment because the another innovation or another innovative thinking that coming into communication is actually legal. นะครับ right now we need to have a lawyer in the communication team. Because of the data privacy. Right now we have the PDPA, which luckily they postponed for another year, the Data Protection Act for Personal Privacy. So if they have a Data Protection Act coming in, right, the way that digital collect data, we have to change. We have to inform the person that we collect that data. And that person has to allow us to use that data first before we can use it. And that's going to change a lot of way that we do communication already. Let's say that you are a member of one restaurant, and one restaurant has your phone number and your name. If this PDPA coming in, that restaurant has to inform you that I have your mobile phone, nah, and I will call you later on. If you don't allow it, they have to delete that information. And that's going to be quite big. Actually, in the hospital, that we have a lot of patient innovation. Patient data in our collection, right? Because they are our patient, they have to we have to acknowledge them, that we have what data, and we have to have a lead time to delete all those data according to the law, and that's how the government or the law is trying to protect us from data leaking, and data management, and we have to prepare now, even though we have 1 year ahead. It takes a lot of time to understand the data, the sensitivity of the data, and how to manage it, and reconsent all those data back to our collection before we can use it again.
Yeah.
Now it's a big project that I'm working on right now.
Actually, in the kinds of literacy, we used to aware about the issue of information literacy a bit sometime. And then we jump to digital literacy. And then right now, digital literacy seems to be kind of fundamental for all the new generation because they're born with the digitalization. But people get back to information literacy now, right? What kinds of information that can be concerned, can be protected, can be kinds of this kind of thing. So this is the reason why this program have the module that training our student about the information literacy, digital literacy, and the OER, the open educational resources that anyone can use it and make it for free, this kind of thing. So I think that by this kind of phenomenal communication still, technology is a must. Innovation is a need in this kind of new normal kind of that. Yes, since you are the innovation collaboration, innovation creator, innovation user, what will be your last conclusion for the audience, please?
Okay, hope you get something out of this session. Then I think the key thing is that we have to not be afraid of innovation, because it's a tool. The core thinking of the communication process or communication theory remains the same. It's just changing of tool from television to YouTube, right? From telephone to line, from a newspaper to Instagram. That's it. So it's just a tool to use. If we understand the strategy, the approach of communication, and then we understand the tool, it will be throughout from end to end. The most important and the core thing is to understand communication first, understand people that you want to talk to, and understand yourself or what you are selling. That's the key.
Thank you so much. Understand the humanism, understand communication, and understand strategy. And like now, since saying that in this year of 2020, we are talking about 5G, right? And then the young generation, they are talking about the TikTok. also your son, right?
My son also play TikTok with his mom.
Okay, I think that the audience in this room also he's a guru in TikTok, Mr. Cham. Mr. Cham, you would like to share something with me, our speaker tonight, Mr. Cham? TikTok, Dr. Fong, Dr. Jun, anyone else? And then Ajahn Dalalat, please, would you like to share with us for tonight, please?
Okay. Can you hear me, first of all? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. I think the presentation tonight is very interesting and for us to move forward is all these things is all about lifelong learning. And it's very important that instead of competing each other, we have to collaborate in order to reach the goals together for success in the business or etc. And it's really lifelong learning, I mentioned, and also this is academic social skills that we have to learn, and it has to be a mix. As Sora mentioned, between science and arts, and people have spent so much time that attention on things is very short. So we have to make sure that we can grab that attention and either sell things or to advocate for better environment, sustainable development, etc. So I think this leaves a lot of questions for us and food for thought for us to think further and see how like ASEAN can move forward as one identity, one ASEAN within this new norm or this people.
Very good insight, Ajahn Dalalat. Yes, I do agree that even though the jumping or disruption of technology and innovation, but human beings still the heart of everything, right? And then since you mentioned about lifelong learning, yes, we cannot stop. We need to keep going on. But since all the technology is very jumping, we alone cannot cope it up. I think that we cannot cope up. So this is the reason of kind of the collaboration, partnership, and alliance strategy is coming to use. So I think that with the key or the strong of technology, it might be the great opportunity for ASEAN to make use from technology to make our ASEAN identity is to be very strong and clear. So it seems like Khun Sola would like to say something and then say goodbye to us.
ได้ครับก็totally agree ครับ lifelong learning and that's why I'm back to school again. And actually sustainability is my dissertation actually. I'm study on the corporate social innovation ครับAnd that's how the CSR and innovation come together, and all the company can help making betterment not only for themselves but for the society and people already to all together. But that's my dissertation that I'm writing at the moment. So I think the conclusion is very clear. It's all up to human or up to us to understand all this tool and theory and how we can communicate them positively to help out other people and collaborate together. And similarly to what I showed at the beginning, we need to have 285 people in the company, and each of them has a different expertise. And in the team, might be 30 people together working on one project because they bring different specialization into the project. And we deliver that to the client or to the consumer, to society. And that's where I think where the future moving toward. The collaboration together, helping each other, and use technology as a tool.
So I think that by the coming few months, 3-4 months, Please welcome back to share with us about social innovation under the name of Dr. Sola Kiatanarat. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Thank you so much. Sawadika. Thank you. Okay, so thank you so much for all the audience. So it's let me listen to your feedback for tonight, please. Connie. Any feedback from the session from you tonight?
It's interesting topic because it's a new normal that we like the routine nowadays.
Yeah. We need to use it, right? We need to, right? Like now, many of the communicator, they lost their job because they cannot be like a digital literacy. They cannot make kinds of digital devices well, kind of that. That is one of the reason that they lost their job, right? Okay. So, Suchat, how are you? Albert?
I'm fine.
Yeah.
And you?
Yeah, very fine. What about the feedback from tonight's session?
I think that using mobile phone increased cheating, and the problem is that how we cope with that issue or that problem.
So the actually that there is a the coils, right? We have to anchor up the coils that the positive and negative, right? But it's kind of it's a must. Nobody can avoid from that. So we need to like Ajandalala said, we need to get along with that and then literate from that. That's why the global. We have the subject that is a fundamental for all the kids in the kindergarten to learn about digital literacy. In America, they have seen the kindergarten, they talk about the hate speech, they talk about the fake news, they talk about in the kindergarten, kind of that. Okay. So, Kunwala, please, what is your feedback for tonight?
Thank you, Professor Kimonlat. So did he leave from this meeting? This instructor Sola leave from meeting. She gone.
Yeah.
So actually I have the sensitive question that I would like to ask him, and I expect I can ask him in the class. So never mind, I can ask you instead, professionals, Kamalap.
I can send the question to him. He's my student. He's my PhD student. Yeah. Yes.
That sounds good. So in Thailand, we have the four main carrier. That's I think half of Thai people do it, like a farmer, like a food garden, like a fisherman, like a seller at the fresh market, a seller at the grocery. So I think in COVID-19, most of them are lose their job, lose their career because they did not understand or did not know how to access, how to use the rapid innovation. This is the problem that the instructor Solas, his position, I think he are in power to promote, to enhance the roles or the manual user to every people in Thai country. So in Singapore have the agency, have the government agency to promote, to make the people understand how to access the innovation how to use like a have a menu to the citizen, Singapore citizen, that I would like to ask him how to promote, how to teach the Thai people who have who did not access to internet.
Oh, this kind of question is kind of we talk about like now there is a technical term that is say that disruption. So meaning that this is fast change, and another one is a transition. Transition is kind of gradually. It's like a bridging. So in the sector of farming sector, kind of that, there is a transition from the senior farmer and the young generation farmer. For the young generation farmer, we have a pop up a lot of smart farm in the country of Thailand, or even in ASEAN, like in Vietnam, we have a lot of popping up smart farm. So, and then most of the smart farm engagement is more on the young generation. You just imagine that, Connie, you have the twin with 2 years, like they have the digital skill, right? They can use smartphone, right? Yes. So meaning that the young generation, they have the other DNA. They are Gen Z, Gen connected. Once they're born, they can connect it with the digital. My grand nephew also, he's about 2-3 years. He can call me with the video line conference. And then kind of like, even though he cannot literate at all, he don't know how to read and write this kind of DNA. So meaning that in this kind of transition is very challenging. So the percentage of the marginalized Konti Chai Corp, the marginalized group and the active group, kind of that. So Khun Sola, he is working with the global industry media, kind of that. So he talk, the headquarter of IPG is in New York. So we talk about the industry media, kind of that. It's very high end. We talk about the AI, we talk about kinds of things. But once he doing his dissertation, he talk about social innovation. It's very upside down, you know. So this is his inner thought that the innovation is a must for the underserved people. Innovation and technology is not for only the high-end people. It must be belong to the underserved people too. So this is the reason why he's saying that, wow, right now many people saying about CSR, the social responsible for the society, but sometimes it's kind of the illusion of or the fake CSR or kind of that. So he's come up to seek the answer of, hey, how can we transfer innovation into the society and make the equity into the society. So in case of the issue that you raise up is, I think that you are exactly that com person. The question you raise every week is exactly belong to the marginalized people. Yes. If we talk about any kinds of the marginalized or the underserved people, the street workers, the street seller, the grocery, small grocery, the gardener, the janitor, the unskilled laborers, kind of that. This is the reason why Thailand has popped up one agency that we call TPQI. Thailand Professional Qualification Institute, SKQI, TPQI. So meaning that the educational institute cannot help this kind of disruption. So the nursing, they also have the Saphakan Payaban, the Saphakan Chat, or kind of that, to be the professional association to disrupt this kind of change. And for the nationwide country, we have the Thailand professional qualification. For example, if you want to be the taxi driver, we will certify you. And then we will put the sticker to you to certify that you are the legal or the professional taxi driver. And if you are the beginner ICT man, you would like to work in Vietnam or you would like to work in ASEAN member country, they have the APQI. A mean ASEAN. ASEAN Professional Qualification Institute. They have the VPQI, Vietnam Professional. They have the PPQI, Philippines. So meaning that all the ASEAN member country, they have aware. They have realized that there is a problem for the underserved people that they cannot get along with the disruptive technology, because to the technology is mostly very, very expensive, very difficult to access if you are not have that much money or have no skill of that. So I think that this question of yours is linked to the question of yours last week about the telecommunication. Telecommunication, we'll meet you next week to clarify you some part. I would like to say that the duty of telecommunication, for example, like everyone is familiar to UN, right? United Nations. If we talk about children and the youth, we automatically think about UNICEF, right? If we talk about education, culture, heritage, we automatically think about UNESCO, right? If we think about the kind of ITU, ITU is the International Telecom Union. ITU is like the agency of UN that taking care only about the ICT of the growth. That's why we have to put the telecom into the academy of our us. The ITU is the agency that have to taking care of the digital divide globally. Digital divide globally. For example, that I used to share with you that I forgot. During Thaksin Shinawatra, president, prime minister, Thaksin Shinawatra, during that time, I forgot the year. During that time, Thailand has no ministry of ICT, right? At that time, no ICT. Thailand has been labeled in a warning sign that your country is under the digital gap, digital divide. It's a big gap between the urban and the rural kind of that. So Thaksin Shinawatra set up the Ministry of ICT at that time immediately. Then he popped up kinds of the telecenter or the ICT remote area, the ICT kiosk all over the country, even though some work, some don't work. But that is the indicator that try to build up the digital divide between the well-served and the underserved people, kind of that. So I share this issue with you because I would like to release your worry about that nobody can escape from digital divide, because it's the duty of UN to taking care of digital divide. But it will be fast or not fast or not. So like I used to share with you, I used to went to South Korea in the last 20 years back. During that time, South Korea and Thailand similar. We have the paddy field, we have the farmer, we have the small farmer, we have the poor farmer, similar the same. But once the policy of South Korea, they make a digital policy into the country, like India in Bangalore, in kind of that, they use a policy in moving ICT digitalization, then the country move and change kind of that. So that's the how. So in this kind of your question about the left behind the exclusion of some underserved people. This is the duty of all the country, and UN have to follow up. So that's why the UN, they have classified or categorized the country to be the well-developed, underdeveloped, developing country, kind of that. And then they use this kind of indicator to make it. So I think that the industry of innovation, industry of technology is some sector of the society, but nobody can avoid that. So even though we are in the education sector, in the medical sector, we need to use innovation also the same, right? And even they are the farmer, even they are the street worker, they cannot avoid. Everyone, when you see the statistic that Khun Sola has shown up, it's more than 100% of mobile phone owner, right? So meaning that Connie, how many mobile phone you have? One, two, maybe. Kind of. You have one mobile phone, you have one tablet, you have one computer notebook, kind of that, right? So this is very sure that accessibility is okay by the middle end, like us, we are the middle end. But for the last mile people, the underserved people, is so soon, right? And education is very change a lot. So I think that Ajahn Dalalat, you would like to share something about this in this kind of technology and innovation that make digital divide or the transition to be well digitization people for the country, kind of that. Yes?
I will try to say it again. My computer is very bad tonight. Can you hear me? Otherwise, yes. I will type.
It's better now. It's better now. Yes.
Yeah. In fact, one thing, like a sorry students, just be patient with me. One thing that I observe, like when we have like the technology go really fast, and based on the story presentation, we have to be very specific to get the consumer buy thing. I think maybe I better write it down because it's very difficult. Yeah, I can see from your faces.
Right now it's clear.
Yeah.
Right now it's clear.
It's just like the other side of technology. When it's very easy for us to buy things online, we can shop anytime, anywhere, and anything. At the same time, there are the dark sides of the technology as well. For example, like there are bad guys who also buy illegal products online. They also have access to technologies similar to us. And in my organization, the organization that I'm working with, we are talking about like the dark web, where you can buy anything, even like a human trafficking. I mean, all those stuff, the porn items and illegal wildlife products. So this is one big issue that ASEAN communities, especially the law enforcement sector, trying to combat.
I agree with you. Actually, I used to discuss in the policy discussion forum in South Korea among the kinds of the transparency and good governance. And then South Korea is very proud to share that. In the old time, South Korea corruption is very, very remarkable. It's very notorious. It's not that good. It's not that different like in Thailand now, right? So meaning that the corruption is very high, the country is very difficulty in the development. And then since they use ICT to be the tool for the move of the country, the ICT can make more participation, the ICT can make more transparency, and then ICT can left behind some of the digital footprint into kinds of many of issue of the police, big issue of the country. So, and then make it declare to the public, and then the law enforcement is very strict also. And then since ICT have come up into the policy drive of the country, it seems like the corruption is very slow down, and then finally come up to be very least in South Korea. So meaning that this is the smart side of the technology, right? And then if the people in any country is very well educated in kind of the technology and digitalization, I think that that will be a good for country to use digital tool to make in any kind to facilitate to make it transparent, to make it good governance, to make it lifelong learning, or to make kind of that. But we confess that in our country, digital divide still, but it's better betterment, it's keep developing from day to day. Have that, yes. Mm. Okay. Any sign from you, please?
No.
Smile.
That's your answer is very clearly. Thank you.
Because my duty for about 20 years is to fill up a digital divide. So that's the reason why. And then by this year, the Princess Clinton marked that the minimum of 55,000 Hmong have to be accessed to the digital Bali. Bali is the main languages of the Buddhism. If the Hmong in the Buddhism cannot understand Bali, that means Buddhism will dying. So this is the policy of Princess Clinton that we have to use digital to empowering the Hmong. And then many people say, why need to be digital? And then it's come up that in many of the remote or temple, no teacher to teach Bali. So the teacher who can teach Bali is normally about 70. 80 wow. Have that, and the young monk is Lai Suchat. He's very young, and the generation gap make it difficult, you know. So Princess Clinton saying that put Bali into the mobile phone. Put Bali into mobile phone. That is the first thing, and the second thing that is Princess Clinton want us to do in this year is put the digital, I mean, put the medical content under scope of the caregiver, the caregiver for the aging into the mobile phone and learn it with the online learning in the MOOC massive open online course. And then by this year, we will certify with the Thailand TPQI Professional Qualification Institute to produce the general community to be the certified caregiver for the aging, not less than 5,000. Normally, if I were the general community people, no education, but I have 18 year olds. And then I got trained from the Ministry of Humanity Welfare, Kasuong Pomor, in the caregiver's package, 17 ounce, 70 ounce, and then 200 ounce have that, and then the Ministry of Pomor will certify me. But by this Princess IT, she's saying that work with the Sapha Kan Phayaban, the Nursing Council, and Sapha Kachat, and then make it happen to certify this caregiver for the aging. So meaning that this general people in the remote area, they can be trained and been certified by the mobile devices to be the certified caregiver in this year. And then if this model is success, meaning that the Sapha Kan Phayaban and Sapha Kachat will move on top to be the nurse aide. Nurse aide, you just imagine that Puchuay Phayaban. So Puchuay Phayaban, you have to take a training course of 510 hours from the digital training. So meaning that if you are very poor person in the underserved area, but if you can learn from mobile phone, no need to go for the formal education, you can be the nurse aide in your own community. So this is kind of the how we use the digital tool in its smart way to empowering the people, kind of that. So this is the how. Okay, yes. So there is a lot of change, I think, right? A lot of change. And then Khun Sola also confirmed that the technology, we cannot cope with that. It changes every day, right? It changes every day. But how can we make it? How can we balance it? So that is the reason why we have to group together. Like himself, he is the director of the Association of Media Agency Association of Thailand. So he worked with many agencies of Thailand and then control each other because self-regulation, group regulation, professional regulation, this kind of that your question about. So the by the government side, sometimes it's quite slow. But in the sake of the professional association, is more active type of that. Okay.
May I ask a question, yes, please?
Yes, please.
So, if it's possible that we can create the law before the innovations occurring, can it be because we have a many professional or many specialists from the digital innovations, they can accuracy predict how is the trend of the digital innovation will be. So if it's possible, can we write the law or impose the law before innovation occurs?
If you can predict the innovation and technology, I think you are God.
So that I saw from the instructor Solar Statistics have a graph that predict the innovations occur or predict how to innovation to be in the future. And if it's impossible to write the law.
Actually, the law is kind of is very legit, you know. Innovation and technology is quite unpredictable. I think it's just a lovely prediction. Nobody know about the kinds of the COVID-19. Nobody know. Nobody will accept kinds of e-learning kind of that. And nobody know about TikTok or kind of this kind of thing. And in kind of TikTok, there is a lot of issue that's talking about kinds of hate speech, kinds of abuse speech, kind of discrimination, kinds of a lot of things happening up, right? And then the law is kind of the, it's just a frame with the fundamental principle. And then, but it needs to be very flexible. I think we have a friend that is a good in TikTok, Cham. Would you like to share about TikTok? Cham, are you there? He's a guru in TikTok and live, and then there's a lot of challenging kind of that.
Yes.
Okay, you can share even in Thai or in English. What do you think about the technology tonight?
It's good. I have ได้ความรู้เยอะมากเลยครับผมอาจารย์สัญญาผม
สถานการณ์TikTok ที่แชมป์ทำอยู่เป็นไงบ้างลองแชร์ให้เพื่อนฟัง
หมายความว่ายังไงครับสถานการณ
์ด้านดีด้านไม่ดีด้านเสี่ยงด้านอะไรเงี้ย
อ๋อตอนนี้เหมือนกับ TikTok เขาพยายามแต่ก่อนนะครับเหมือนกับคนที่เล่น target ก็จะเป็นเหมือนกับว่าโชว์แบบมีความเป็นแว้นเยอะอะไรเงี้ยตอนนี้ TikTok เขาก็พยายามที่จะเปลี่ยนระบบของเขาเองนะครับหมายถึงว่าส่งเสริมคลิปที่ให้ความรู้แล้วก็พยายามแบบเซ็นเซอร์สิ่งที่มันแบบล่อแหลมหรืออะไรประมาณที่มันไม่ดีพวกเนี้ยฮะใช่ประมาณนั้นครับ
เพราะนั้นไอ้ TikTok บ้าๆบอๆ crazy TikTok เนี่ยมันก็จะถูกแบนไปอย่างเงี้ย
ม
ัน
ก็จะมันไม่เชิงฮะแบบ crazy มันก็เป็นอีกแบบนึงนะคือแบบสำหรับแบบ funny type เขาจะแบ่งเป็น category อ่ะครับผมเป็นแบบ TikTok ที่ให้ความรู้ผ่อนคลายแบ่งเป็น business อะไรประมาณเนี้ยฮะก็จะแบบแยก category ใครที่แบบดู category ไหนบ่อยๆเขาก็จะจัด algorithm ไปใน category นั้นๆประมาณนั้นครับเพียงแต่ว่าพวกที่แบบบางทีแต่ก่อนมันจะมีแบบโชว์โป๊เปื่อยบ้างอะไรบ้างหรือว่ามีคอนเทนต์ที่มันสุ่มเสี่ยงเงี้ยเขาก็จะเริ่มแบนอย่างเงี้ยครับ
ก็ยังไปได้อีกไกลเนาะ TikTok เนี่ยอีกสักพักนึง
ใช่ตอนนี้ก็ขึ้นเป็นเขาเรียกว่าไงมีเดียที่เติบโตอันดับหนึ่งของโซเชียลมีเดียแล้ว
ถ้าเทียบกับไลฟ์นี่ก็คือ TikTok นี่ก็คือต่อยอดจากไลฟ์มาใช่ไหม
มันจะคนละสไตล์กันครับอาจารย์เหมือนกับอันนี้มันเป็นเหมือนกับเป็นบล็อกแบบสั้นๆอย่างเงี้ยดูแล้วก็ถ้าเกิดใครที่มีคอนเทนต์ที่มันเยอะไปอีกเขาก็จะเด้งเหมือนกับซิงกับโซเชียลอื่นๆอีกประมาณเนี้ยครับ
ก็เจ้าพอ TikTok นะมีใครจะถามไหมเล่น TikTok
ผมไม่ได้เล่นไม่มีแอคเคาท์ครับ
ไม่มีเลย
ไม่ได้แล้วนะครับทุก
คนไร้สุขภาพบางคนนี่อาจจะมีแบบว่า TikTok ประเด็นสุขภาพวันละต็อกวันละแท็กอะไรก็ว่าไป
อันนั้นก็เวิร์กใช่ครับก็เริ่มมีแบบเภสัชคนนึงก็เริ่มสร้างตัวตนนะฮะเหมือนกับบอกทิกเรื่องสุขภาพการเลือกกินยาอะไรประมาณนี้ตอนนี้ก็แบบมีคนติดตามเพราะเราเยอะมากเลย
ผมขออนุญาตสอบถามนะถ้าเกิดมีคนติดตามเยอะมากเนี่ยครับจะมีการได้รับผลประโยชน์จากคนที่มาติดตามครับเขาจะแอดโฆษณาเข้ามาใน
คือตอนนี
้ TikTok ใน Facebook อะไรอย่างนี้ป่ะ
ครับ TikTok ประเทศไทยยังไม่มีแต่ว่าตอนนี้ครับอย่างที่ต่างประเทศเขาจะมีแบบเป็นการ donation donate นะครับเหมือนกับเวลาเราชอบใครเราก็สามารถ donate ได้มีการไลฟ์มีการอะไรตอนนี้ TikTok ประเทศไทยก็เริ่มพัฒนาแล้วเริ่มแบบว่าใครที่มียอดฟอลประมาณ 100,000 แล้วมั้งครับก็คือสามารถไลฟ์ผ่าน TikTok ได้ใช
่โอเคคืนนี้แชมป์ก็ได้อะไรไปพอสมควรเนาะอาจารย์โป้งอาจารย์จูนมีประเด็นอะไรไหมคะอาจารย์โป้งอาจารย์จูน please any reflection ไม่มีนะคะโอเค so the we get back to our class for tonightI think that right now the in your Moodle you just continue with your media literacy right in the media literacy of 01 we talk about information literacy media literacy digital literacy and OER so that one just follow that and then we will have the speaker to talk with you about this issue actually Chandralat she is very good in media literacy Chandralat so you might talk about kind of media literacy, or we invite some person to share, right?
Next Sunday, right?
Next Sunday, I think that will be the telecom, right?
Yeah.
The information literacy is a U-turn back again, because people cannot discriminate what kinds of good, bad, abuse, hate, information, that's kind of, that is literacy in CELO 1. And then for the CELO 2, you are the traveling with the intercultural com. I think intercultural com is a magic or the highlight of our program. So I think that we find out the speaker to share with you about this. So that's just entertain with your clip. And then for the final exam, actually it will be by the end of July, but since the COVID is postponed to be early August, but they not fix the date yet. But it will be very soon in early August. Once I know, I will really inform you. So because you want to come back to Thailand, right, Khun Vala? Yes, okay.
Not yes, because I already registered examinations overseas already.
Yeah. No problem. It's very flexible, because in this COVID situation, everything is very flexible. And then I think that is all. I think that is all. So you are so worried about the final exam. Don't worry. So because the Moodle assignment is 70%, and mostly all the teacher have checked it, and then they will feedback to you so soon. So that's it, right? So just enjoy. And then for example, next time will be about the telecom. So just prepare yourself about the telecom, and then you can discuss with them. That's it. And then you can also you can also propose some issue that you would like to know more, and then we'll invite them to share with you. Kandala, do you like to say something tonight? You look very tired tonight, right?
No, it's just sick of the computer.
Yeah. I do understand. So we allow you to be relaxed tonight. So the who else that would like to share? Ajahn Pami, would like to share something tonight? What's up? Ajahn Pami?
No, ha.
You're okay, right? And then Ajahn Chun, Ajahn Pong, you like to say something, and then we can say goodbye for tonight.
Oh, Ajahn, I would like to ask Ajahn Pong about dashboard.
Dashboard, yes.
Yes.
Oh, dashboard, the percentage, the dashboard. Yes. Mm. What is the status of dashboard? What is it?
It looks like it shows the percent that we lead. So in subject 17701, I list all of lessons and all of modules, but it's total 23%. And the subject 177002, I list it totally, but it shows 6%. So I don't know what that means. So and how I should read, how I should do to make it more percent.
Okay. คืออ่านครบแล้วทำครบแล้วเนี่ยมันยังเป็น20กว่าเปอร์เซ็นต์หรือ6เปอร์เซ็นต์เนี่ยจันป้องจันจูนว่ามันเป็นเพราะอะไรคะ
ไม่รู้ว่าต้องทำถึงกี่เปอร์เซ็นต์หรือมันจะต้องแบบไหนถึงเราจะรู้ว่าอ๋อนี่เราถึงจุดแล้วนะเราโอเคเราถึงละแต่ตอนนี้เราก็อ่านไปแล้วก็ยังไม่รู้ว่ามันถึงจุดหรือยัง 6% มันใช่ไหมหรือมันขาดตรงไหนออกไปอีกลืมทำกระดาษส่งหรือเปล่าเขาต้องเช็คมันเลยทำให้เกิดการความกังวล
มีคำตอบไหมคะหรือว่าต้องไปถามระบบคะอาจารย์อยู่ไหมคะสงสัยคงออกไปแล้วออกจากระบบแล้วโอเค
เดี๋ยวผมถามไปในไลน์กรุ๊ปก็ได้ครับ
เดี๋ยวอาจารย์ปาง follow เรื่องนี้เนาะวันนี้ก็มีแชมป์มาอยู่กับพวกเรานะคะก็โอเคทุกคนมีความสุขดีนะ
ค่ะ
มีคนน่าเหนื่อยอยู่คนเดียวอาจารย์แหม่มโอเคสุชาติอยู่โอเคไหมสุชาติวันนี้อยู่แบบว่าพอเทคโนโลยีมาสุชาติเฉาเลยอยู่เนี่ยเป็นเจนนิวเจนนะอยู่จะต้องสมาร์ทกว่าใคร
อ
ย่าไปรีเจ็คเทคโนโลยีเพราะเทคโนโลยีถ้าเกิดเราใช้มันดีจะทำให้ชีวิตเราง่ายขึ้นแล้วพอเราไปต่างประเทศนะถ้าเกิดไม่ใช้เทคโนโลยีไม่เป็นเนี่ยแย่เลยมีอยู่ครั้งหนึ่งอาจารย์ไปนิวยอร์กพอไปถึงเขาก็ไปที่เคาน์เตอร์ไปเคาน์เตอร์เสร็จเขาก็ยื่นบัตรให้ใบเดียวในใบนั้นเนี่ยก็ไม่ว่าอะไรเลยก็คือมีสลิปเล็กๆให้รีจิสเตอร์ให้ล็อกอินในห้องให้เก็ตaccount บัญชีโอ้โหแบบ totally แบบ confused เมื่อ10ปีที่แล้วนะ 7-8 ปีที่แล้วคือทุกอย่างมันดิจิทัลเซชันหมดเลยว่าตอนนี้คือเราอย่างอยู่สิงคโปร์นี่ก็น่าจะเยอะมากนะนี่ไปจีนยิ่งหนักเลยตอนนี้ใช่ไหมเพราะนั้นไม่ใช้ไม่ได้เลยในเจนเนี้ยโชคดีที่อาจารย์เนี่ยแก่แล้วจะตายไปก่อนแต่ไอพี่เด็กรุ่นใหม่เนี่ยต้องเจออะไรเยอะแต่ว่าพอเห็นพฤติกรรมของเบบี้ในยุคนี้เขาก็โอ้โหขวบสองขวบนี้เล่นสมาร์ทโฟนกันวิวแล้วใช่ไหมคนนี้ลูกสาวหรือลูกชายคะ
ลูกสาวค่ะ
ลูกสาวสองทั้งคู่เลยเมื่อไหร่จะเอามาโชว์บ้างนอนกันหรือยังเนี่ย
ยังไม
่โอเคแล้วก็ใช้เทคโนโลยีกันเก่งไหม
เล่นค่ะคุยไลน์แล้วคือแบบกดอะไรได้หมดเลยค่ะ
นั่นแหละเด็กสมัยใหม่เพราะฉะนั้นไม่ต้องห่วงเขานะแต่พวกเราต้องตามให้ทันเพราะเราต้องใช้โอเค bye tonight very happy to meet you all and then see you next Sunday bye bye ค่ะ bye bye สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีครับ